Hey Rose, it's Friday, June 20th. So this weekend we are leaving for California, so naturally I've been packing. And while packing, I found a couple of shirts that I wanted to bring, but they were just a little bit too big on me, so I threw them in the wash to shrink them. As you do. While I was standing over the wash waiting for my clothes to be done, I thought to myself, you know, I've always known that washing certain fabrics on high heat can shrink them, but I've never thought of why this happens. Honestly, you'd think it'd be the opposite. Adding all that hot water and agitation, you'd think the fabric would kind of loosen and stretch out. However, ask anyone who's ever washed a wool sweater in hot water, and they can tell you that's not how it works. First, let's take a look at fabrics in general. If you were to zoom into the fabric of, say, your t-shirt, you would see that it's actually made up of tiny threads that have been woven together into a matrix that we think of as a fabric or a cloth. Zoom in even smaller to one of these specific threads and you'll see that it's made of tons of biological strands of hair or fiber. Zoom in even farther to this hair or fiber and you'll see that it's made up of tiny molecular chains held together by hydrogen bonds. That's right, we're getting all chemistry up in here! Some fabrics, like cotton, are made from the fiber of a plant that has been spun into thread and woven into fabric. Meanwhile, something like wool is when instead of taking fiber from a plant, you take fiber from an animal, aka its hair. And then you spin that into yarn and weave that into a cloth. So, shrinking happens a little differently based on what fabric we're talking about. In cotton and other plant-based fabrics, when the fibers are spun into thread and woven into fabrics, the molecule chains become stretched and twisted and pulled around each other. Therefore, the hydrogen bonds that hold those molecule chains together become stressed. When washed, the added energy from the hot water and the agitation of the washer actually causes these hydrogen bonds to break, allowing the fibers to relax and fall into a more condensed state. When you extrapolate this out over the billions of molecules in your shirt, you'll see that the threads actually now take up less space, and therefore the shirt is smaller. Fabrics made from animal hair behave slightly differently. The fibers of animal hair are much thicker and denser, so the breaking of molecular bonds is not likely to change much of the fibers themselves. Instead, it is the actual texture of the hair itself that causes the shrinking. If you remember the video I made about why we get lint stuck in our belly button, you'll know that our hair is actually made up of tiny scales that are arranged like the shingles on your roof. This allows for things to travel along the hair easily in one direction while getting caught trying to travel in the opposite direction. Precisely why lint ends up in our belly button, since the hair on our stomach grows inwards towards our navel. Well, when these hairs are made into fabric, these small scales actually hook onto one another and hold each other in place. This is actually one of the reasons why wool is so strong and durable. However, when you add the extra energy of the hot water and the agitation from the washer, this actually causes these scales to tighten down on each other, almost as if you were ratcheting them closer together. This causes the yarn to take up less space, and alas, now your old Christmas sweater is a crop top. I love learning about this kind of stuff. The things that we experience all the time but just never take the time to think about, that's some of my favorite stuff to find out about. Everyone, have a great weekend, and Rose, we will see you on Monday, our 5-year anniversary in California. Yeah, you can be jealous. Peace.